so your car won't start but it's making some noises. Here's some sample of noises and causes so you can identify them. Hi, I'm Andrew from Qualified Auto Electrician. We've all been in the situation where you're in a frantic rush, you're running late and finally jump in the car and the car won't start. So today we're going to take my old Hilux, we've had this girl for a while, we're going to break it, the unbreakable Hilux, and make some noises and show you what they mean and the causes from them. So to do this today and to help me, I'm going to need my beautiful assistant Briohny. Here she is, excuse the sunnies, it's very bright here. And we're going to stick her in the driver's seat and she's going to be my cranker. So we've got my old Hilux, 2.7 litre, four cylinder. This engine's been around for ages. We all know the noise it should make, which is... Thank you. So basically that's what it should sound like. You'll hear the starter motor initially crank over quite well and the engine fire within 3 or 4 RPM. So that's really what you're looking for. And when you don't get it, let's go through some now. Okay, so what we've done here is we're simulating a starter motor in this one. So there's two real things that go wrong with starter motors. Either the old one that everybody talks about is a solenoid. Solenoid's got contacts, it's a plunger that comes down and it makes a loud click. The click sounds like this. Cool. So what happens is you get in your car, you hear that loud, solid click. That's generally, it's either starter contacts or a battery terminal, which is how I've simulated it. The other thing that goes wrong with the starter motor is when they run out of brushes. In which case you won't get anything, you'll just have your dash lights on, you'll turn the key, you won't actually hear anything because the solenoid's not making a contact through. But that loud click is probably the most popular one, or most common one, and you generally get that on anything with a reduction drive starter motor, so all the Toyotas, a lot of Mitsubishis and so on. So that's one down. Alright, so what we'll do now is we'll show you basically what a flat battery sounds and looks like actually. So what we'll do, Briohny, crank away. Cool, as you can hear, it didn't start and it made the sluggish sound and then the machine gun sound. The sluggish sound is the battery sort of low in charge, and then once it does that machine gun, it's actually not enough power to engage the solenoid that we were talking before, so the solenoid's clicking in and out. Another good check, just if it makes that noise and you really want to make sure it's a battery, is just turn the headlights on and you'll notice they're quite slow to come on and they're quite an orange colour. So that definitely, that orange colour gives away that you've also got low voltage going, so definitely a flat battery. In this case, jump starter, away she'll go, and if the alternator's working fine, it'll charge back up. We'd then recommend putting it on a battery charger, getting it fully charged and testing it. Okay, so before when we had the flat battery, we also spoke about the alternator recharging the battery. So there's no real visual noise if your alternator fails, but generally most of the time you'll get an alternator warning light. So what we'll do is we'll simulate an alternator warning light. It's actually the battery light, and a lot of people have confusion. They see the battery light, they think it's a battery fault, but it's actually an alternator fault. So if your alternator light's on, your battery's not charging, and either your vehicle will stop with a flat battery, or when you pull up, you'll try and start it and you'll get the flat battery noise before. So we'll just show you what the alternator light looks like. So I really hope that helped you today with a couple of noises and a few checks to carry out if your car doesn't start. Although it's always handy to understand what is happening with your car, some situations are not always a cut and dry diagnosis. We always recommend getting your vehicle professionally diagnosed by an auto electrician, and that way you won't run into any surprises along the way. Qualified Auto Electrician offers roadside breakdown assistance. Get in touch with us on 1300 227 353 or email info@ame.net.au.